Good morning, all of you. Today we are going to start a new chapter, and that is the name of the chapter is Understanding Quadrilateral. In this chapter, we are going to study today's topic is polygon. So, what is polygon here? It is a simple closed surface made up of line segment. A polygon, it is a simple closed curves made up of line segment, only line segment is called a polygon. Means it is a simple closed curve, means it should be closed curve and made up of only line segment plus closed curve plus line segment, and thus it will form a polygon. Suppose I am making a diagram like this. These are all line segment and I am joining this. These sides are all line segment and it is forming a closed loop. So this is a polygon. Simply I can make like this. This is also a polygon and it is closed also, made up of line segment. I can make this also. So this is also a polygon having closed surface. Similarly, but these are polygon with closed line segment. If I make this as, these are made up of line segment but these are not closed curve, means this will not be a polygon. Similarly, if I make it like this, so these are also made up of line segment but it is not closed. So, these will not be a polygon. Now, we will study the classification of the polygon. Here, I have written in classification. Types of polygons are triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, heptagon, hexagon, octagon. These are the classification of polygon. Triangle is having how many sides? 3 sides. And the figure of the triangle will be like this. This is a triangle having 3 sides. Similarly, quadrilateral, the word quad suggests 4. So, how many sides? 4 sides. And I can make this as like this, means 1, 2, 3, 4. Quadrilateral is having how many sides? 4 sides. Similarly, pentagon. Penta means, the word penta means 5. So, how many sides? 5 sides. So, I can make pentagon as 1, 2, 3, 4 and this 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, pentagon is of 5 sides. Similarly, hexa means 6. So, this is 6 and the polygon made with 6 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is hexagon having 6 sides. Similarly, heptagon. Hepta means 7. So, it will be of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, how many sides? 7 sides. So, heptagon's having how many sides? 7 sides. Similarly, octa. The word octa means 8. Means it will be of how many sides? 8 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 sides. So, the word octa means 8 and how many sides? 8 sides. Similarly, nonagon means 9 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 sides. Deca means 10. So, how many sides? 10 sides. So, I will make here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and this is 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. So these are the classification of polygon, where classifications of the polygons are written, and how many sides does this polygon have, and what is the figure of this sides. I have explained in this the classification of polygon. What do you mean by diagonal here? A diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive line segment. Sorry, non-consecutive vertices. So, a diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices. Suppose if I draw a figure like this, this is a rectangle naming as A, B, C, D. So this is a rectangle A, B, C, D. I have to draw the diagonal of this rectangle. So I will join A, C and D, D, B. So A, C and D, B is the diagonal of this rectangle. Similarly, if I 1, 2, 3, 4, suppose I am naming this figure as A, B, C, D, E, F. I have to find the diagonal of this. So what I will do, I will start from the these A, B, B, C, C, D, E, D, E, E, F and F, A are the sides of this. So what will be the diagonal for this? A, B is joined, so I can connect A with C, again A with D, similarly A with E, and A and F is connected. So these are the diagonal. Again from B, BC is connected, I can draw BD. This is the diagonal BD. Again, I can connect B with E, B with F, and AB is already the side. Again here, if I see BC, BC is connected, C is connected with D also, but C is not connected with E. So I can draw one diagonal here with E. Similarly, I can connect C with F. AC is already connected. Similarly, from D here, D I will see. DE is connected, D, C is connected. DB is again connected, DA is connected. I can draw this with as DF. So this is the diagonal. Again C with E, EF is connected, AE is also connected, AB is also connected, AEC is also connected, and ED is also connected. So these are the diagonal of the polygon. Now the next topic is exterior and interior. Exterior means outside, and interior, the word in suggests, means inside. Suppose I am drawing a curve like this. So this is the interior portion of this curve. This is the interior portion of this curve. Again, if I will draw a curve like this, so outside this is the exterior part of the curve. This is the exterior part of the curve. Interior means inside, exterior means outside. Similarly, if I draw a triangle A, B, N, C. Angle A, angle B, and angle C. These are the interior angle of the triangle. If I extend this triangle, so this angle, these are the exterior angle of the triangle. So what understood? What is interior angle? What is exterior angle? Interior curve and exterior curve. And the next topic is type of polygon. Here I am having four types of polygon, naming this as, first one is concave, convex, regular and irregular polygon. So the types of polygon is classified into four types. First one is the concave polygon, second is the convex, and third is the regular polygon, and the fourth one is the irregular polygon. In concave polygon, the at least one angle should be greater than 180 degree. In concave angle, at least one angle should be greater than 180 degree. Similarly, in the concave, it should be less than 180 degree, means all side of this angle should be less than 180 degree. Here it should be greater than 180 degree. In regular polygon, all the angles and all the side of the polygon should be equal. All the angles plus sides should be equal. And what is irregular polygon? It is the opposite of regular polygon, where all the angles and side will not be equal, means all sides plus angles will not be equal. So this will be a irregular polygon. Suppose if I draw this, this will be like that. Here in concave, what it's happened, at least one angle should be greater than 180 degree. If I see this angle, it is greater than 180 degree. So this is a concave polygon. Similarly, if I draw this, here the sides and angles are less than 180 degrees. So this is concave polygon. In regular polygon, if I draw, means all the angles plus all the sides should be equal. If I draw a square here, in square, you know, all the angles and all the sides of the square are equal. So this will be a regular polygon. In regular polygon, I can take the example of a trapezium. Suppose this is a trapezium where the sides are also not equal, and the angle forming here, this will also not be equal. So this is the type of polygon where we have studied four types of polygon, that are concave, convex, regular and irregular. In concave polygon, at least one angle should be greater than 180 degree. Similarly, in convex, it should be less than 180 degree. Similarly, in regular, all the angles plus side should be equal, and all the angles plus side should be equal. And here in regular, the opposite of regular, all sides plus all angle will not be equal. In the previous video, we have studied about the angle sum property of a quadrilateral, where I have proved the theorem. So you can watch from the previous video. In this theorem, what it says that suppose I am having a quadrilateral like this, naming as A, B, C and D. In this theorem, it says that the sum of all the angles, means angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D, will be equal to how much? It will be equal to 360 degree. Means in angle sum property of a quadrilateral, it says that angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D, it will be equal to how much? It will be equal to 360 degree, because this is a quadrilateral. This theorem is proved in your previous lecture, so please go and watch from there. And similarly, if I write angle sum property of a triangle. This is a triangle naming as A, B and C. This is angle A, angle B and angle C. In angle sum property of a triangle, it says that angle A plus angle B plus angle C, it will be equal to how much? It will be equal to 180 degree. So remember this, this will be used in many of the questions. So in quadrilateral, angle sum property of a quadrilateral is angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D, it will be equal to 360 degree. Similarly, for the angle sum property of a triangle, it will be equal to angle A plus angle B plus angle C, it will be equal to how much? 180 degree. This is exercise 3.1. Here the first question says that given here are some figures, here I have drawn some figures. You have to classify each on the basis of first one is simple curve, second one is simple closed curve, third one is polygon, and the fourth one is convex polygon and concave polygon. So let's start with a simple curve. So see, in the first polygon, here are some figures. In simple curve, it should consist of line segment or curve. So this is consist of line segment plus it is closed also. This will be simple curve. Again, it is a closed loop and it is made up of line segment. So this will also be a simple curve. Here I am having, this is a closed curve, but here two, both are not connected with each other. So this will not be a simple curve. Similarly, this is, I have connected here now. So this is made up of curve and it is also connected. So this is also a simple curve. This is also a simple curve made up of curves and forming a closed loop. So this will also be a simple curve. See here, it is made up of line segment and curve. So this will also be a simple curve. Here in this diagram, this circle is one, this circle is one, and it is connected with a line. So this is not a simple curve. Similarly, the second one is simple closed curve. So first we will go with the simple curves. Which are simple curves? Just check if they are closed curve or not. Here in the first question, see in this figure, this is made up of line segment and plus it is closed also. So this will be simple closed curve. Simple closed curve. Here also it is made up of line segment and so the, and it is closed also. This will form a simple closed curve. Here it is not the simple curve only, so it will not be a closed curve also. Also a simple closed curve. This is also a simple closed curve made up of curves and it is forming a closed loop. Here also this is a curve and line segment, so this will also be a simple closed curve. The next one is convex polygon and concave polygon. In convex polygon, it should be less than 180 degree. Here, if I make an angle, it will be greater than 180 degree. So this will not be a concave polygon. If I see this angle, and this angle, these are less than how much? 180 degree. So this will be a convex polygon. This is not a polygon. Here again you will see this is made up of line segment. If I check the outside of the line, means this angle, so it will be less than 180 degree. But if I check this will be greater than 180 degree, so this cannot be a convex polygon. Here also it cannot be a convex polygon. Here also it cannot be a convex polygon because here the angle will be greater than 180 degree and here also it cannot be a convex polygon. So only one convex polygon we are having here. So the next one is concave polygon. Concave polygons means it will be greater than, at least its one angle should be greater than how much? It should be greater than 180 degree. Here I am getting greater than 180 degree. So this will be a concave polygon. This is already convex polygon, so it cannot be a concave polygon. This also, it cannot be a concave polygon. But here, you can get a concave polygon, because you know the outside of the triangle is less than 180 degree. But here concave polygon, it says that at least one angle should be greater than 180 degree, and here we are getting greater than 180 degree. So I will get here as concave polygon. Here also it cannot be a concave polygon, here also it cannot be. Similarly, here also we cannot get, and here also. So how many concave polygon we have? We have two. This is question number 2. In this question it says is, how many diagonal does each of the following have? Means a convex quadrilateral, a hexagon and a triangle, we have to find out the diagonal. So if I make a quadrilateral like this, convex quadrilateral, naming this as A, B, C, D. So this is a convex quadrilateral. I have to find out how many numbers of diagonals in each of the following. So if I join A with C, I can write down this AC as one diagonal. Similarly, BD as another. So the number of diagonal here is how much? 2. Number of diagonal is 2. Similarly, hexagon. Hexa means the word hexa suggests 6. So how I will draw this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is a hexagon. If I name this as A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, so what we have to find out? We have to find out the diagonal of this hexagons. These are the sides A, B, B, C. These are the sides of the hexagon. We have to find the diagonal. If I connect, it is already connected with B. If I connect A with C, again AC, again A with D, AD will be the diagonal, A with E, so this will be the diagonal AE. Okay. AC, AD and AE either diagonal. Similarly, from the point B, if I check, it is connected with C, so it will be BD. BE and BF. So BD, BE and BD, BE and BF are the diagonal. From point C, CD is already connected. I can connect this with as CE, CF, CA is CD, CE and CF. Okay, so I can write down this as CE, CE and CF. From point D, D is connected, D, F is not connected, so I can connect this. DA is connected, DB is connected. So what is another diagonal? DF. So from point E, if you can see, all the diagonals are connected. So see, these are the number of diagonal. Let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So what is the number of diagonal here? How much? 9. Similarly, in a triangle, I'm drawing a triangle here. A, B, C. I have to draw diagonal of the triangle. Here AB, BC and CD are the sides of the triangle. How can I draw a diagonal? Because already it is connected with each other by their sides. So here, number of diagonal formed is 0. This is question number 3. In this question it says that, what is the sum of the measure of the angle of a convex quadrilateral? So we have studied the first sum, we have studied that sum of measure of angles of a convex quadrilateral. In the previous video I have studied, it is how much? 360 degree. This I have proved this by theorem also. You can go and write down from there. Now, next question says this, which will the property hold it if the quadrilateral is not convex means for convex quadrilateral we know it is 360 degree, but we have to again prove it by if it is not convex. So for the convex quadrilateral you go and watch the previous video. I am doing it for if it is not convex. Okay, so suppose I am drawing a figure here like this. Your angles I am making. I will draw a diagonal like this. A, B, C, D. Okay, this is a non-convex quadrilateral. I am naming this as A, B, C, D. B, D I have drawn the diagonals, and from here these I have named this as angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, and again angle 6. So this is a A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. So this is one triangle and this is another triangle forming here. So in triangle ADB, in triangle ADB, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to how much? It is equal to 180 degree by angle sum property of a triangle. This is by angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property of a triangle says that the sum of the three angles will be equal to how much? It will be equal to 180 degree. This I am naming it as equation 1. Similarly, this is another triangle. I will name this as BDC. So in triangle BDC, angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6. Angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 is equal to how much? 180 degree by angle sum property of a triangle. This will be the second equation. Okay, now what I am going to do, I am going to add both the equations. So adding first and second, by adding this two I will get angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6. If I have added the left hand side, I will add the right hand side. So 180 plus 180 is 360 degree. From here, angle 1 I can write down this as angle A. Similarly, angle 2 plus angle 6, 2 and 6, 2 and 6 I can write down this as angle D. Again 3 and 4, angle 3 plus angle 4, angle 3 and angle 4 is angle B. So I can write down this as angle B. Now angle C, 5 is angle C. Angle 5 is angle C. So angle 5 is angle C. Okay, see, from there angle 1 is A, 2 and 6 is angle D, 3 and 4 is angle B, and the 5 is angle C. This is equal to how much? 360 degree. So here I am writing this as 360 degree. So on arranging I can write this as angle B plus angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D equal to how much? 360 degree. In the question it was asked ki will the property hold it for the quadrilateral if the quadrilateral is not convex. So the answer is yes. For now, if it is not convex also, then also the sum of the property it will be 360 degree.